It feels like when it comes to LLMs, everyone in the tech community is talking about RAG. And no, not dish rags, but retrieval-augmented generation.
Buzzwords are everywhere in AI circles, but is RAG really the silver bullet it's made out to be? We'll break down what it is, why it matters to build an AI strategy, and bust some myths along the way.
So buckle up, it's time to separate AI fact from fiction. Imagine an AI that never hallucinates, always tells the truth, and knows everything. Well, it sounds too good to be true, right? Well, that's because it actually is. Welcome to the world of AI grounding, where reality meets AI hype.
Let's start with the basics, starting with the overarching term, grounding. It's about anchoring AI outputs in verifiable facts or contexts. It's the difference between an AI hallucinating that the sky is green and one that checks its sources and correctly states the sky is blue.
Now, there are several ways to ground a model. The first, prompt engineering, like giving the model a persona or instructions in the prompt. And then there's providing context or data sources, like including your entire code base in the model's context window. Or RAG, which retrieves data from an external knowledge base or vector database.
So let's focus on RAG. It's like giving your AI a superpowered search engine. Instead of relying solely on its training data, a RAG-enabled AI can pull in external information to inform its responses. Think of it as an AI that can Google before answering.
So why is everyone talking grounding and RAG? Simple. It addresses some of AI's biggest challenges around retrieving data even beyond a model's context window. RAG can potentially make AI more up-to-date and knowledgeable without constant retraining, and make AI more reliable and less prone to hallucinations. It promises more trustworthy, capable AI systems. But there are a lot of myths going around, so let's go ahead and tackle them one by one.
Myth number one. RAG and grounding are only for text-based AI. In reality, these techniques are being applied to multimodal AI systems, including those working with images, audio, or even code. For example, imagine a product information retrieval system. You can search for products based on image queries like find similar shoes and provide detailed product descriptions.
Now, for image processing, the user would upload an image of a shoe. The image is then processed to extract relevant visual features like color, style, shape, and more. And then these features are converted into a numerical representation, which we call embeddings. Now for retrieval. The image embedding is compared to a database of product images and their corresponding embeddings. Similar products are retrieved based on visual similarity. And then product information like descriptions, specifications, prices, associated with these similar products is fetched.
Next, we have language model processing. The retrieved product information is processed by a language model. The model generates a comprehensive product description based on the user's query and the retrieved data. The description can include details about the product style, materials, features, and other relevant information. So before we reveal the other four RAG myths you need to know, yes, we're going to ask, smash that subscribe button.
It may not seem like much, but it really helps our videos be discovered. It's how we keep bringing you more tech, investing, and business content. Myth number two, RAG eliminates the need for large language models. Not so fast. While RAG can enhance smaller models, it still needs a capable base model to effectively use the retrieved information. Look, it's not about replacement, but it's about augmentation. LLMs are still essential for understanding the retrieved information, generating coherent text, and adapting to different query formats. LLMs act as the brain of the RAG system. The effectiveness of a RAG often depends on the size and quality of the underlying LLM. Larger models generally excel at understanding and utilizing retrieved information.
Myth number three, RAG solves AI hallucination completely. If only it were that simple. RAG significantly reduces hallucinations, but doesn't eliminate them entirely. AI can still misinterpret or misuse the information it retrieves. RAG occurs at runtime. That means it happens when an AI model is called. That doesn't affect the training process. So you want to make sure your RAG system is using high quality data, ensures the knowledge is accurate, up-to-date and relevant. Also, effective retrieval, like implement robust search algorithm to retrieve the most pertinent information for a given query. And data validation, like verify the credibility of retrieved information before feeding it to the LLM.
All right, myth number four. RAG always improves AI performance. Here's a shocker, RAG doesn't always make AI better. And in some cases, it can even introduce noise or irrelevant information. The key is in the implementation and the quality of the knowledge base. Look, it's not a plug and play solution. While it often enhances AI systems, there are several factors that can actually influence its effectiveness. For example, data quality. If the knowledge base is inaccurate, incomplete, or irrelevant, it can actually hinder performance.
Another example is retrieval effectiveness. Poor search algorithms can lead to the retrieval of irrelevant or misleading information.
And then you have LLM capabilities. As we mentioned, if the LLM isn't sophisticated enough, RAG might not yield significant benefits.
Next, you have task complexity. For some tasks, the LLM might already possess sufficient knowledge without requiring external information. And in such cases, RAG could be redundant or even detrimental.
And then, of course, there's computational overhead. Integrating RAG can actually increase computational costs and latency, potentially offsetting performance gains.
Myth number five, RAG makes AI outputs completely unbiased. Unfortunately, biases can exist in the retrieved information or in how the AI interprets it. RAG helps, but it's not a magic wand for eliminating bias.
Yeah, there's still data bias. The knowledge base used in RAG might contain biases reflected in the original data.
Retrieval bias, like search algorithms, can be biased, leading to the retrieval of information that reinforces existing stereotypes.
And then there's LLM bias. The underlying language model itself might carry biases from its training data.
And let's not forget human bias. The humans involved in creating and curating the knowledge base, designing the RAG system, or evaluating its outputs, it can introduce biases.
Look, RAG and grounding are powerful tools, so let's get that right. But they're not magic solutions. So when you're hearing out there about RAG this, RAG that, remember, it takes real AI planning and the right team and tooling to get it right. And as companies follow this hype and jump on that AI bandwagon, in order to make these models actually useful to their unique business, they'll need to invest in high quality data and diverse data sets to build robust knowledge bases.
They also need the right LLM for their needs and fine-tune it for specific tasks.
And definitely a dedicated team that actually evaluates and continuously assesses their AI system's performance.
And you can't leave an AI model up to its own devices. The reality is businesses need to prioritize fairness, accountability, and transparency in their AI development.